Okay, we'll begin with the invocation. Sit up nice and tall, keeping the collarbones wide, chest lifted up, sitting bones anchored, and maintaining the natural curvature of the spine. Sit up tall. Invocation prayer. Vande Gurunam Charanaravinde Sandarshita Swatma Sukhavabodhe Nishreyase Jangalikayamane Samsara Halahala Mohashantye Abahu Purushakaram Shankhachakrasidharinam Sahasrashirisam Shvetam Pranamami Patanjalim Om. Hands on the knees, palms facing down. Inhale, take a nice deep breath, look up. Exhale, bring the chin to the chest. Inhale, sitting up tall, look up. Exhale, drop the chin to the chest. Bring your head back to the center. Roll your shoulders back a few times. Loosen up the shoulder blades. Roll the shoulders forward a few times. Interlace your fingers, palms facing out. Separate the shoulder blades, inflate your upper spine, and do the flexion with the spine. Come back to the center. Interlace your fingers in the back. Lift the heart. And drop your head back and extend the spine. Release, stretch your arms forward. Extend the wrist, stretch it to the fullest of its possibility, and then flex. Extend and flex. Extend and flex. Make a fist, wrist rotation in a few times. Wrist rotation out few times. Movements at the elbow, bringing the hands to the shoulders in and out few times. Bringing the hands to the shoulders, rotate your elbows in. Loosen up all the joints so that you prepare for your asana practice. Then rotate the elbows out few times. And release. Inhale. Pick up your arms. Interlace your fingers. Palms turn to the sky. Shoulders behind the ears. Elbows towards each other. And push the sky with the palms. Exhale. Samasthitihi. If you know what Ujjayi breath is, do the movements with Ujjayi breath. Inhale. Take a nice deep ujjayi. Pause, shoulders behind. Exhale, bring the hands on the same shoulder blades, elbows in and back. Open the armpits and the shoulders. Inhale, ujjayi. Pause. Exhale, right hand onto the left shoulder blade, left. Turn to the right shoulder blade. Elbows in. Pause. Inhale. Arms reach up. Push the sky. Exhale. Left hand onto the right shoulder blade. Right hand to the left shoulder blade. Pause. Inhale. Take a nice deep breath in. Pause. Exhale, samasthitihi. Now remove the block if you're sitting on the block. The block will help you keep the hips higher than the knees. Come on to your hands and knees. Hastabandha, engaging the root of all five fingers, spreading the fingers. Engage the tip and the root of the fingers. Shoulders are tiny bit in front of the wrist. Elbows are straight. Inhale. Drop the abdomen. Lift the chest. Lift the chin and the pelvis. Exhale. Round the spine. Tuck the chin in. Tuck the tailbone in. Separate your shoulder blades. Inhale. Deep breath. Create space between the vertebrae. Exhale, round your spine and pull the pelvic floor in and up. Inhale, lift the chest, lift the pelvis up. Exhale, round the spine. Bring the big toes together. Send your sitting bones back. Separate your knees and go into the wide-legged Balasana, child's pose. Nice long spine. Waist is elongated, chest reaches forward, sitting bones go back and down, and focus on your breath. Deep breathing in and out with calm, meditative mind. Inhale, come back onto the hands and knees. Take the right leg back, keep both the hips in one plane. Take the left arm forward, reach from the hip joint, point the toe, stretch the ankle. Gaze down so that you find the balance and hold it there. One, elbow is straight. Two, engage your core. Three, keep the leg active. Four, and five. Bring the hand down and relax in the child's pose. Coming back onto the hands and knees, switch the side, take the left leg. Keep both the legs in one plane, stretch the ankle, point the toe, reach the right arm and lengthen the whole spine, gaze down, hold it for five counts. One, two, three, four, five. Bring the arm and leg down and relax in the child's pose. In the child's pose, you can keep your arms forward or along the side. See what helps you. Relax in the pose and focus on your breath. Inhale, come up. Sit in Vajrasana with the legs folded back. Interlace your fingers in the back. Roll the collarbones up and back. Squeeze the shoulder blades together. Inhale, take a nice deep breath in. Exhale, work on opening the front of your chest. In opening the shoulders by reaching the arms vertically up. Take some nice deep breaths there. Try to keep the elbows straight. Inhale, come back to the center and relax. Anahatasana, keeping the hips in line with the knees. Thighs are vertical. Open the chin, throat, armpit, chest towards the floor. Keep the pelvis anchored back and up. Elongate the spine and focus on your breath there. One, two. Keep opening the armpits towards the floor. Reach the chin, throat, and chest to the floor. Traction the spine. Take some nice deep breaths there and then come out and relax in the child's pose. And then we'll do some postures lying down on the back. Lay down on your back. Keep the left leg bent. Reach the right leg up. Interlace your fingers behind the leg. Iron out the back of the right leg. Reach as far as you can. Maybe catch the foot. If not, you can interlace it behind the calf muscles. Keep bringing the leg towards the midline. Keep the right sitting bone down and away. Reach the left leg, point the toe, activate both the legs and lengthen the spine. At the end of exhalation, gently try to take the cervix back and up, or pelvic floor in and up. That's your Mula Bandha. Gently take the lower abdomen in and up. That's the Uddiyana Bandha. Breathe there with calm, meditative mind. Gaze at the right big toe. Stretch the backs of your legs. Keep straightening the knee. This will prepare you for all the forward folds. Stretch your hamstrings. Take the right leg down. Keep the right knee bent. Iron out the back of the left leg. Reach the left leg up and bring it towards the midline, keeping the left sitting bone down and away. Then see if you can reach with the right big leg toe towards the wall in front of you. Stretch the right leg. Keep it super active. From the hip joint, reach to the wall in front of you. Breathe nice deep breaths with calm, meditative mind. When the posture gets difficult, breathe even more deeper. Always taking the control over the breath. And then take both the legs up. Point your toes, stretch your ankles. Try to bring the navel towards the spine so that the lower back is anchored to the floor. Squeeze the legs together. Ankles, knees, and thighs are squeezed together. Continue to breathe. Come down slowly for the count of 10. One, keep the legs supercharged. Two, hug the legs together. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. And slowly come down and relax completely. We'll do Pavan Muktasana. Inhale, arms reach overhead. Exhale, interlace your hands closer to the ankle, bring the right knee towards the right shoulder, and relax and take some nice deep breaths there. Massage the right side of the abdomen with the thigh, pressing the abdomen, and with calm mind, hold the posture. Release the right leg and relax there. Inhale, arms reach overhead. Exhale, bend the left leg. Interlace your hands closer to the left ankle. Bring the knee towards the shoulder and hold the posture. Continue to breathe nice deep breaths. And release and relax completely. We'll do Pavan Muktasana with both the legs. Inhale, arms reach overhead. Exhale, hug both the legs. Press the thighs onto the abdomen. Try to hold your elbows if you can. And lift your head and bring the head to the knees if possible. Tuck the chin in. Stretch the back of your neck, so that even the neck and shoulder muscles get stronger. And then relax, bring the head down and release and relax there. We'll do Jathar Parivratasana. Keep the arms along the side at the level of your shoulder. Hug the knees into the chest. Inhale. As you exhale, bring the knees towards the right elbow, look to the left. Try to squeeze the legs together and keep the knees together. If that's not happening, maybe squeeze a block between the legs. Inhale, take the knees back to the chest. Exhale, bring the knees towards the left elbow, look to the right. Try to keep the upper body grounded. Inhale, come back up. Exhale to the other side. Inhale, come back up. Exhale to the other side. Inhale, come back up. Exhale to the other side. Inhale, come back. Exhale to the other side. Inhale, come back and release and relax. Keep the feet wider than the hips. Keep the arms along the side. Do Markatasana. Drop the knee towards the opposite foot. Elongate your waist and bring the knees side to side like a windshield wiper. From here, release and stretch the legs. Keep the arms along the side. We'll do forward cycling motion. So bend the right leg. Make big circles. When you bend the knee, you bend it all the way. When you stretch the leg, stretch it all the way. Make big circles with your legs. Point the toe, stretch the ankle when you stretch the leg. And reverse, making big circles. Reverse cycling motion. And then come bring your legs down and relax completely. We'll rotate the whole of the leg from the hip joint. Point the right leg, reach it to the sky. Keep the leg super taut and straight, knee straight, ankle stretched, toes pointed. Inhale and then begin bringing the right leg big circles in clockwise direction. Once you make three big circles, reverse, make the three circles in anti-clockwise, opposite direction. From your hip joint, you reach. And when done with three rounds, bring the leg down and relax. Reach the left leg up, point the toe, keep the knees super straight. And stretch your ankles. Take clockwise three rounds with the left leg. Big circles. Then when you're done with three rounds, take it in the opposite direction. Three rounds, big circles. Do all your movements mindfully and with understanding. Bring the leg down and relax completely. We'll now do Ananta Asana. So lie down on your right side. Stretch the right arm overhead. Take the left hand to find the balance and stack your feet, stack your hips first. Then bring the hand under the head. Rest there and stay there. See if you can raise the leg up and down a few times with its own strength. Each time increasing the range of motion. Then catch hold of the ankle or the calf muscle. Walk your hands up as far as you can and then breathe there. Stay centered, don't lean back. Stretch your leg from the hip joint. Breathe. One, two, three, four, five. Bring the leg down, lie down on your back and switch the side. This time take the left arm overhead. Find the balance with your right hand. Keep the hips stacked. Use the core to find the balance. Maybe raise the leg up and down a few times. Activate the core. Activate all the leg muscles. If you keep the knees straight and the ankle stretch and toes pointed, all the muscles in the leg will get activated. And then catch the ankle or calf muscle. And walk the hand as far as you can and breathe there. One, two, three, four, five. And release. Bring the leg down. Lie down on your back. Hug the knees into the chest. Roll from side to side. Rock back and forth. And come up in downward facing dog. Sending the sitting bones back and up. Push the floor and release the whole of the spine. Bring the chest towards the floor. Open the armpit. Stretch all and every part of the body. And breathe into that part of the body. Really give yourself a nice length. From there, walk your feet forward slowly. And come into a standing pose using one vertebra at a time. You may come up into Samasthiti. Now take a ball and we'll
front, back, sitting bones go back, chest goes forward. Look between your hands. Hands are at least as wide as the shoulders. Sitting bones are back, separate them. Knees are pulled, kneecaps are pulled up, legs are super straight. Breathe there, traction the spine. One, two, three, four, five. Walk back to the wall and relax there for a moment. Now we'll do modified Virabhadrasana 3. Walk your legs back. Send the sitting bones back. Heart lifts up, extend the chest forward. Kneecaps are pulled up, arms are lengthened, legs are lengthened, backs of the legs are lengthened. Everything is nice and long. Keeping the weight onto the left leg, reach the right leg up. Keep the right hip in line with the left hip. Reach and stretch from the hip joint and hold it there. Breathe, look between the hands if possible. One, two, three, four, and five. Take the right leg down. Switch the side. First, make sure sitting bones are behind your ankle. Then you shift the weight to the right leg. Point the right left leg, reach and lift it up, reach to the wall behind you. Keep the left hip down in line with the right hip. Lengthen and reach and breathe. Look between the hands if possible. One, two, three, four, and five. Bring the leg down, walk back to the wall, and relax there completely. Okay, we'll do a few movements with Talasana Vinyasakrama. Feet together, come onto the tops of your mat. Stand nice and tall, shoulders rolled back and down, arms are along the side. Inhale, Ujjayi. Take a nice deep breath in, interlace your fingers in the back, push the sky with the palm, shoulder behind the ears. Pause. Exhale, Samasthitihi. Inhale, 6 second inhalation, 3 second pause. Pause. Exhale, hands on the same shoulder blades. Open the armpits, elbows in and back. Inhale, Ujjayi. Pause. Exhale, right hand onto the left shoulder blade, left hand to the right shoulder blade. Pause. Inhale, arms reach up, Ujjayi. Pause. Exhale, left hand to the right shoulder blade, right hand to the left shoulder blade. Pause. Inhale, arms reach up. Ujjayi. Exhale, Samasthitihi. We'll do one spiraling motion with airplane arms. Inhale, airplane your arms. Ujjayi. Lift your heart. Exhale, look back over the right shoulder. Inhale, come back to the center. Lift your heart. Exhale, look back over the left shoulder. Inhale, come back to the center. Pause. Exhale, Samasthitihi. Okay. We'll do one balancing pose. If you need your wall, you take the wall. Shift your weight to the left foot. Take the right leg up. And plant the foot nicely. Toes are facing down. Knee is nice and open. Keep the body nice and taut and see if you can find the balance and hold it there. You may keep whatever arm position you like and keep opening the right knee. Supporting leg is straight and breathe. One, two, three, four, five.
Open the arms and bring it down and relax. This is going to strengthen your hip joint. When you do the balancing posture, there's so much weight that comes on one hip. Try the other side. Put the foot against the thigh. Open the knee. And taut body will help you find the balance. Keep the right foot toes spread and arch lifted up. Always keeping the Pada Bandha and Hasta Bandha in mind. Lift the heart, elongate the waist. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Release and come out of the pose. We'll prepare for sitting postures, keeping the feet hip width apart, all four corners of the feet equally rooted, engaging the arches of the feet. Stretch the arms forward, slowly come down into Utkatasana, dropping your hips down all the way, relaxing the hips, keeping the knees separate, lift your heart and keep releasing the hip down. Relax there and take some nice deep breaths. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Sit down and Dandasana. Keep the toes towards you. Lift your heart up. Stretch your legs in front of you. And roll your collarbones back and up. Look at the tip of the nose. Nasakre Drishti. Bring the chin to the chest. Jalandhara Bandha. Stretch the back of the neck. Take some nice deep breaths there with sound. Throated breath. Paschimottanasana. Inhale, arms reach up, elongate the spine, using the hip as a hinge. Take the lower abdomen in and up, Mula Bandha and Uddiyana Bandha. Reach forward and stretch your spine. If this is too difficult for you, you may keep the knees bent. Spine is nice and long, breathing is deep. Stay there. All the forward folds are very calming for the mind. Taking nice deep breath there. Relax there. And slowly come up. We'll do the counter pose. Chatushpada Pitam. Feet together. Knees together. Hips are closer to the ankle if you can. Take hands one foot behind. Hands are tiny bit wider than the shoulders. Keep Hasta Bandha. Inhale. Lift the pelvis. Track the knee forward. Drop the head way back. And hold it there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Slowly come down and relax. Keep the feet wider than the hips for the Bhunamasana. Sit up tall. Inhale. As you exhale, bring the head to the right and back. It's okay if the left hip comes off the floor. Inhale. Come back up. Exhale. Switch the side. Inhale. Come back up. Exhale. Switch the side. Inhale, come back up. Exhale, switch the side. And then come back up and come back to the center. We'll do Janu Shivasana A. This is a very, very important pose because it's almost like Mahabandha. You can engage all three bandhas in this pose. Make 90 degrees, square your hips. Both the hips are equally facing the front. And take your foot, inhale, lengthen the spine. Lift the heart, nice deep, long spine, and then drop the head, Jalandhara Bandha, and long spine, take some nice deep breaths there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Inhale, lift the head,
Exhale there. Switch the side. Janu Shirsasana A on the other side. Sit up tall. 90 degrees, the legs open. Right hip comes back. Square the hips. Take the foot. Elongate the spine. Inhale. As you exhale, you may drop the head. Do Janandhara Bandha. Elongating the spine. Take some deep breaths in. One. Two. Three. Four. Five. Inhale. Head lifts up. Exhale there. Now we'll do Baddha Konasana and Upavishta Konasana. Take the block. If your hips are very tight, it's good to sit on the block because that will help you open the hips. And you bring the feet in, dropping the knees down and thinking of stretching the knees apart from each other. Open the soles of the feet, sit up with the heart lifted up and feel an intense stretch in the inner thigh muscles. Keep external rotation at the hip joint and take some nice deep breaths there. One, keep the spine nice and long, heart lifted up. Do not slouch and drop your lower back. Lift the heart up and elongate the spine, broad chest. Deep breathing there. And then release, come out of that to Upavishta Konasana. Separate your legs about 90 degrees. Toes are facing up, kneecaps are pulled up, these muscles are tight so that the back of your legs relax and open. Sit up tall. If you like and if you have a good balance, reach your arms up, stretch the spine, bring the shoulders behind, tighten the quadriceps, the front of your thigh, and take some deep breaths there. One, keep lifting the upper back. Two, three, four, five, and release and come out of that pose. Okay, we'll do one twisting pose, Vakrasana. Bend the right leg, right goes over the left knee. Keep the right foot anchored, hook the elbow to the shin, stretch this outer thigh muscles, bring the knee in. Broad chest, take the right hand back, push the floor and open up the whole of the waist. Both the waist are elongated. And breathe nice deep breaths, look back. Spine is always long in twisting pose, do not collapse. And release, do the Vakrasana on the other side. Bend the left leg, take the left foot over the right knee. Hook the elbow to the shin, lift the heart, push the left hand onto the floor and look behind the left shoulder. Nice long spine, broad chest. One, stretch the outer thigh of the left leg, bring the right left knee in towards the chest. Two, three, four, five, and release and relax completely. We'll do core strengthening posture, Navasana. Lift the legs, squeeze the knees together, ankles together, thighs together, and support your leg with the hands if you like. Do not collapse, lift the chest. Maybe bring the hands in the back and support. See if you can lengthen the legs and straighten them. Or if it's possible, let go of your arms. Use the modification that works for you as long as the chest is lifted up and you're taking nice deep breaths. One, two, three, four, five. Bring it down and relax your head. Do Navasana two more times. Reach and use the modification that works for you. Taking deep breaths. One, two, three, four, five, and release and relax. Navasana one, last time. Use the modification again. If you need to keep your knees bent, keep them bent as long as there is no strain in the lower back. Keep the heart lifted up. One, two, three, four, five. Bring it down and relax. And then come out. We'll do Gomukhasana. Sit in Vajrasana. If Vajrasana is not possible for you, sit in Sukhasana. Okay, and sit up nice and tall, maintaining the natural curvature of the spine. Take the right arm forward, reach from the shoulder blade. Turn it in from the shoulder. Take the right hand between the shoulder blades. Maybe use this hand to bring this elbow in. Then reach this left arm, stretch it, stretch it. Keep reaching the sky and then fold it. Interlace your fingers and lift the heart to look up. Both the elbows are in. Breathe nice deep breaths. If your hands are not clasped, use a strap or a dupatta and walk your hands towards each other. Breathe there. Hold it for 5 deep breaths. And when done, come out of the posture and we'll switch the side. Take the left arm, reach through the shoulder blade, turn in from your shoulder, bring the hand in. Use this hand to bring the elbow in if needed. Take this right arm, reach the sky, stretch the whole spine first, then simply bend the elbow, clasp the fingers, lift the heart. Lift your heart and stretch the throat to look up. One, two, three, four, five. And come back out and relax in the child's pose. We'll do some back bending postures, laying down in the prone position on our tummy. So lie down on the abdomen, keep the chin on the floor, tops of the hands are pressing the floor. Feet are together. Inhale, reach the right leg up from the hip joint, keep the legs straight, keep both the hips in one plane, keep reaching to the wall behind you and lifting it up from the hip joint. Breathe. One, two, three, four, five. Bring the right leg down, turn your head to one side and relax. Ardha Shavasana on the other side. Bring the chin on the floor. Keep the feet together. Inhale. Reach the left leg up from the thigh. Lift it from the hip. Reach to the wall behind you and elongate. Breathe. One, two, three, four, five. Bring the leg down. Turn your head to one side and relax. Purna Shalbhasana. Feet together if possible. If they don't come together, it's okay to keep them apart. Chin on the floor. Interlace your hands in the back. Open the collarbones and the shoulders nice and wide. Inhale. Legs lift up. Heart lifts up. Chin lifts up. Look at the tip of the nose. Reach to the wall behind you. Breathe. One, two, three, four, five. Bring the legs down. Turn the head to the side and relax. We'll do the Sphinx pose. Reach the arms forward. Walk the elbows in. Keep the heart lifted up. Keep lift up, lifting out of the shoulder. Don't collapse. Lift up. Create a lot of space in the lower back. Breathe nice deep breaths there. One, two, three, four, five. And then from there, Come down and relax. Bring the arms along the side. Push yourselves back into Balasana, child's pose. We'll do one more back bending posture before we go to inversion. So lie down on your back. Keep the feet tiny bit wider than the hips. Bring the feet in. Toes are in, heels are out. Arches of the feet are lifted up. Inhale. Lift the pelvis up. Lift the hips up to the sky. Exhale there. Pull the cervix back and up, or lift the pelvic floor as if you want to suck the pelvic floor, perineum in and back. Then relax, bring the pelvis down. Do that a few times. Inhale, lift the pelvis up. Exhale, draw the cervix back and up, or the perineum back and up. Relax, and then bring the pelvis down. We'll do one more time. Inhale, lift the pelvis up, hips to the sky. Exhale, draw the lower abdomen in and up. Draw the pelvic floor back and up. Relax, bring the hips down. And move your knees side to side, release the lower back. Take the happy baby pose. Hold the outer margin of the foot. Keep the shins vertical. Soles of the feet are facing sky. Knees come toward the floor. Roll your back side to side. Keep opening the hips by drawing the knees towards the floor. Massage the lower back and then release. Bring the legs together and relax there. Now we'll do the postures for inversion so that we use the gravity to help us with a lot of the ailments that we have because of the gravity. So go on closer to the wall. Sit along the side of the wall. Then from there, swing your legs up, draw your hips closer to the wall. And if you have a block, use the block to lift the hips and up. So you can keep the block under your sacrum. Take the block under the sacrum, keeping the legs completely relaxed. Lie down there and just focus on your breath. Watch your regular breath. Watch how the abdomen goes up as you inhale. How the navel goes in as you exhale. You can use this pose even towards the evening before you go to bed. It will help you calm down and get ready for a good night's sleep. So just staying there with calm mind. Hold the pose and relax completely. You can even hold it for 10 minutes. Since it is supported and there is no effort required, you are simply relaxing there. This will also help anybody who has varicose veins, pelvic floor prolapse. It's a very good pose, even for anxiety. It will help you really relax. So maintain this, stay there for a few minutes. Relax completely. And if you're ready to come out, you may come out, or you may pause the video and hold it longer. In interest of time, I'll come out. Now, we'll use the wall to increase the mobility at the hip joint. Keep the legs vertically up the wall, feet together. Arms are along the side, maybe at the level of the shoulder. Slide the right leg down along the wall, bring it all the way down. And then inhale, slide it back up. Do that movement 3 times. Exhale, bring it down all the way. Inhale, bring it back up. Exhale, bring it down. Inhale, bring it back. Then switch the side. Take the left leg down, bring it down. Inhale, bring it back up. Exhale, use the wall, slide it down. Inhale, come back up. Exhale, bring it down. Inhale, slide it up and relax there. The next pose is so that you learn how to lift the pelvis for Sarvangasana. Slide yourself a little bit away from the wall so you have enough room to press the feet and lift the pelvis. Keep the hands anchored onto the floor. You're going to push the floor with bent knees. Inhale, lift the pelvis up. Support your pelvis with the hands. The weight is on the arms, shoulders, and elbows. You're supporting the pelvis. Not much weight on the neck and the head. Then exhale, bring it down. You may do repeat this several times by lifting up and bringing it down, each time increasing the range of motion. And if you like, you can just hold it there. Squeeze the thighs together, keep the feet together, and hold and take some nice deep breaths there. Then when you're ready, bring the pelvis down, bring the feet down, hug the knees into the chest, roll to the right side, and with support, come up and sit in Sukhasana, happy sitting pose. If you have ability to do Ardha Padmasana or Padmasana, do so. If not, just sit in Sukhasana. Hold your arms in the back. Inhale, lift the heart. Exhale, fold forward from there. Take some nice deep breaths there with calm mind. Inhale, come back up and release the hands. We'll do few pranayam practices just as an introduction to pranayam. Ujjayi breath is throated breath. You constrict the throat muscles. So instead of making the sound from the nose, you make the throat sound. So inhale, take a nice deep breath in. Exhale, empty out completely. Inhale, Ujjayi for 6 counts. Pause. Exhale, Ujjayi, 6 counts. Pause. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale.
pause. Exhale. Gather the mind at the eyebrow center and rest in the after effect poise of your pranayama. Nadi Shodhan Pranayam. Again, Ujjayi is the foundation. Close the right nostril with the thumb. Index finger, middle finger, point the third eye center. Exhale. Empty out all the breath through the left nostril. Ujjayi. Close the left nostril. Inhale through the right for the count of six. Close the right, exhale through the left. Inhale through the left. Close the left nostril, open the right, exhale, Ujjayi. Inhale through the right. Close the right, exhale through the left. Inhale through the left. Close the left, exhale through the right. Inhale through the right. Close the right, exhale through the left. Drop your hands down, interlace the fingers, left thumb crosses the right, close the fist, put it in front of your bladder, gather the mind at the third eye center, and rest in the after effect poise of your pranayama. Do not do pranayama with a rushed mind. With calm mind, do your practices. Conclude with the prayer. Hatha yogam vinanaiva Raja yoga prasidhyati Raja yogam vinanaiva Tatva jnana prasidhyati. Tatva jnanam vinanaiva. Buddhiresha nivartate. Vina buddhi nivruttim tu. Moksha varta katham bhavet. Moksha varta katham bhave. Vadiyam vastu govinda tupyameva samarpai. Vadiyam vastu govinda tupyameva samarpai. Then rub your palms, create nice warmth. Apply the warmth to your eyes and your face. And then with few blinks, you may open your eyes.